हेलो चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस कन्वेक्शन इन गैसेस इन फ्लो ऑफ हीट. सो आई एम गोइंग टू दिस एक्सप्लेन यू दिस टॉपिक विद द हेल्प ऑफ वन एक्टिविटी. ओके, फॉर दिस एक्टिविटी वी विल टेक अ क्लोज्ड रेक्टेंगुलर ग्लास बॉक्स विद टू होल्स ऑन इट्स टॉप. Fit two white glass tubes to form chimneys. Put a small lighted candle below one of the chimney. Hold a smoldering piece of paper at the top of the other chimney. Okay. You are seeing this paper, smoldering paper. Okay. We will see smoke entering the box through this chimney. It then gets heated up by the candle. This smoke is heated up by the candle and comes out of the other chimney. As the air above the candle gets heated, it becomes light. Okay, children, the air above the candle gets heated and this air becomes lighter and it goes up, rises up. It is replaced by fresh air sucked in from this chimney. And what is there? There is a smoke. So this smoke is sucked. The smoke is sucked in along with air and sets the convection current shown in the box. You are seeing the smoke is coming from here and going up. Why? The reason behind this candle is making the air present here light, and this light air along with the smoke goes up and it creates vacuum this side. So to fill up this place, the fresh air comes or cold air comes from this side. But what happened here? What is there? Smoke. So smoke is sucked to fill this place. Okay. Now children, one more example of this is sea and land. Convection in gases, one more example is land and sea. Land and sea, please. Children, as we know, sea and land breezes are actually convection currents. We know that water has a higher heat capacity than land. This is water. Okay. Water takes more time to heat up than the time taken by land. This is land. This is water. Okay. During the day, what happened? When the sun is there, during the day, land heats up more than water. Land heats up quickly and cools down quickly. So during the day, land heats up more than water. If we compare, this is hotter than water. The air above the land becomes hotter and lighter and rises up. So the air here is hot and light, it rises up. So the place is created by here. But come to this side, this hot and light air rises up, the air above the sea, which is cooler and heavier, it rushes, the air above the sea is cooler and heavier, it rushes and takes a place. Okay, take the place created by hot rising air. Therefore, a sea breeze blows during the day. Now come to the night, when the sun is not there, what happened? Moon is there. Okay. During the night, the land loses heat faster than water. As I told you in the beginning, land heats up quickly and cools down quickly. Water takes time to heat up and takes time to cool down. The air above the sea is still hot and it is going up. Okay? It is going up. But the air above the land is cold and heavy. Okay? This air is rises up and the cold air from the land rushes to take its place. Okay? This is what land is. So during night, what takes place? Land breeze, and during the day, sea breeze takes place in coastal areas. So this is the example of convection currents. Now we are going to discuss application. Application of convection currents. Children, in houses, like earlier times, okay, ventilators were provided high up on the walls. This was because the air we breathe out is warm and lighter, and this air rises up. Warm air escapes from ventilator. It is replaced by cool and heavier fresh air coming from doors and windows below. Okay, second, central heating in buildings is based on the concept of convection currents. Normally, water or oil is heated in a boiler. This sets up convection currents in the water or oil, because of which it circulates through pipes that go through the room. So this way, central heating system they make in the buildings. Now next, we are going to discuss, next topic is our radiation. Radiation does not need any medium. There is another method by which heat reaches to us. This method is called radiation. Like sun, we get the heat of sun by radiation. By this method, this is what radiation. The energy so transferred is called radiant energy. It does not need any medium to get transferred from the hot body to cold body. Like in case we have seen conduction and convection, they require medium, okay, like solid, liquid or gas, but in this case it doesn't require any medium. Radiation can take place whether a medium is present or not. If it is medium is not there, then also it will take place. Medium is there, then it also take place. So whether a medium is present or not, radiation can take place in all the conditions. The heat from the sun reaches to us through millions of miles of empty spaces by radiation only. Okay. Now, children, all objects around us, they radiate heat. They radiate heat to the surrounding. For example, I'm telling you, our body radiates heat to the surroundings and receives heat from it by radiation. The higher the temperature of the object, the more is the heat radiated by it. Achha, children, one more thing I am going to tell you. Absorption of radiant heat. It depends on color also. I am going to explain you with the help of an activity. We will take two identical tin cans. Okay, paint one of them with the black and the other with the white. This is black and this is white. Okay. Half fill both of them with cold water. We have filled them with cold water. Cover them with cardboard lid and insert thermometer through the lids. We have covered it with the cardboard and insert thermometer through lid. Okay. Place both the cans in the sun. Note the thermometer reading after 15 minutes. Now heat both the cans to the same temperature and keep them to shade. Note the temperature after every minute. So children, in first case, when we have placed them when we have placed them in the sun for 15 minutes, what has happened? We will find that when the cans are placed in the sun, the temperature of the water in the can painted with black rises more than that of water in white can. This happens because black objects absorb more radiant heat than the white one. Okay, in the same period of time. We will also find that when the cans are placed, second condition, in the shade, then the black color can cool down faster. So what we are concluding by this activity, we conclude that a black object absorbs or radiates more heat than white objects in the same time period. Okay. Now we are going to discuss the application. This thing where we can use. Okay, we wear white or light colored clothes in summer as they absorb less radiant heat and keep our body cooler. Dark colored clothes are suitable in winter as they absorb more heat. Electric room heaters, second one, they are provided with a polished metal surface behind the heating element. This surface reflects almost all the radiant heat from the heating element that falls on it. This makes the room heater more effective. Next one is the outer base of cooking utensils is painted black so that it absorbs more heat. The back of refrigerator are colored dull black to radiate heat more effectively in order to cool down the refrigerator pipes. Okay, next is electric hot plates are also colored dull black to radiate maximum heat. Now children, we are going to discuss preventing loss of heat in thermos flask. A hot object loses heat to be surrounded things by convection and radiation, or by all three means. Similarly, a cold object gains heat from the surrounding by these three modes of heat: conduction, convection and radiation. So to keep the body hot or cold, we need to reduce the loss or gain of heat respectively due to these three modes. So thermos flask is the best example. A thermos flask is a household item that is used to keep things warm or cold for a long time. It consists of double-walled vacuum flask. You are seeing double wall, okay? Inner side, outer side, double walled. Okay? Between the inner and the narrow region between the inner and the outer wall is evacuated of air and sealed together. You are seeing this is sealed, vacuum sealed. What happened? This is outer wall, this is inner wall. We remove the air and we create what? Vacuum. Okay? Now the walls are silvered, the vessel is put in a metallic case and is separated from it by cork or piece of support. Plastic support. This is cork, this is plastic support. So this is vessel which is like double wall. From between these two walls we have removed the air and we have created vacuum. And the inner wall of this is polished with the silver color. Okay. And we have given support with the plastic or wood, as you know, they are what? Insulated. This prevents the glass vessel from breaking. By this support, we can prevent this glass vessel from breaking. The mouth of the vessel is closed by a stopper. This is what? Stopper. Make of an insulating material like cork or plastic. The vacuum between these two glass walls, this is vacuum, okay, between the two glass walls of the thermos flask considerably reduces the flow of heat by conduction and convection. As we know, conduction and convection, they require what? Medium. So no medium is there. Here there is no medium. Okay, vacuum is there. So inner side, whatever the liquid is there, it is not going to lose its heat or coolness because no medium is there. It is not going to lose its heat by conduction or convection. Okay, this is because both conduction and convection, they require molecules of a medium for transfer of heat. So molecules are not there, no air is there. Okay, the silvered surface, inner side, the silvered surface reflect back the heat. You know, polished surfaces, they are good reflectors. It reflects back the heat. Reflect back the heat, thus reducing radiation. So this way, thermos flask protects the cold, like heat of the hot object and coolness of the cold object. So that's all, children. That's all.